think that would be everyone. Is anyone expecting anyone else? Okay, so I'm gonna take time with my speech. How about that? Okay. So good afternoon, everyone. My name is Alan Orlandi. I'm a band director here at ERJ. Before I get started with my long traditional speech, I'd like to welcome Mr. Steve Spanning, our upper school director and principal, to say a couple of words.
Thank you, Alan. I appreciate the introduction and the opportunity. Thank you, parents. Good evening, good afternoon. Thank you, students. It's lovely to see you all here. I'm told that Mr. Allen gives long speeches, so I'm going to keep this one short, I think. But you know, one of the things that I think is really cool about the arts is it's different from the other after-school activities that we have, different from the other parts of our curriculum that we have within the school. And if you think about something like athletics, you see the game as it's being played, but you see a number of games before you get to something like a championship or something like a tournament. And we don't really have that opportunity all the time with the arts and things like the performing arts and band and like the play that we had last night, where we don't see the practice that leads up to the big thing, to the big performance. Parents, you get to see it from your own child, or maybe your own children if they're both playing at the same time, but you get one piece of that. What we get to see in something like tonight with a concert is really the culmination of a lot of individual efforts, combined efforts that we have here at the school during our classes. So it's a really cool thing, where for me, I get little snippets when I walk by and I can kind of pop my head in and go, oh, this is sounding great, this is really cool, I can't wait to see this. You as parents get to hear your own child's individual progression as they practice at home. And I can't imagine what it feels like for someone like Miss Stella last night or for Alan tonight when he gets to see all of this that he has seen come together individually and collectively on the stage. And it must be an incredibly proud moment, not only now, but also when it's all finished. And especially for the students who you're about to see perform. So I really appreciate you all being here. I'm happy to be here. And really just please enjoy yourselves.
Okay, time for the long speech. So welcome all to our holiday concert. Okay, good evening, parents, guardians, family members, colleagues, and student musicians, which are there backstage. We'll begin tonight's presentation with a series of duos, trios, and solo performances played by the high school band members. Then we will have a brief intermission where you will be able to go to Learning Commons A and B for refreshments and just take a look at the gallery of IB Visual Arts and High School Arts, right? And Design. I forgot Design. Middle School. So all arts and design. Well, before we continue, I'd like to thank Dr. Nigel Winner, our head of school, Mr. Spandering, who just spoke, our upper school principal, Mr. Cheney, our vice principal, and my lovely art department, Ms. Anna Mello, my head of department, which is right here, Carlo Richards, Stella Bratterman, James Casburn, and Felipe Bordal. I would also like to thank, is anyone from the PTA here? Raise your hand. Awesome. Thank you, PTA, for everything you always do. Thank you for the support of music at ERJ. You guys are amazing. I mean, you're part of the band, as far as I'm concerned, okay? And finally, I would like to thank the most important members of this evening, and they are our wonderful band members and their families. Your trust, support, and dedication to playing or listening to music has transformed students' lives and this school's institutional appreciation of music. For that, I express my deepest gratitude. Obrigado. Now let's get to it. Well, as is tradition, before I begin, I'll speak a little bit. It's only five pages, I'm just kidding, it's four. However, this year will not be my words, as if you were here in the Fine Arts Evening Concert last year, I pretty much exhausted all my linguistic creativity, right? And I didn't even use ChatGPT. No, today I'm going to read you the opening or the welcome address to the freshman parents given by Carl Palahniuk, which is a pianist and director of the music division at the Boston Conservatory, which is pretty close to Berklee College of Music. He writes, One of my parents' deepest fears, I suspect, is that society would not properly value me as a musician, that I wouldn't be appreciated. I still remember my mother's remark when I announced my decision to apply to music school. She said, "You're wasting your SAT scores." On some level, I think my parents were not sure themselves what the value of music was, what its purpose was. And they loved music. They listened to classical music all the time. They just weren't really clear about its function. So let me talk a little bit about music's function. Because we live in a society that puts music in the arts and entertainment section of the newspaper, if people still read newspapers. And serious music, the kind your children are about to engage in, has absolutely nothing whatsoever to do with entertainment. In fact, it's quite the opposite of entertainment. So let me talk a little bit about music. The first people, or one of the first people, to understand how music really works were the ancient Greeks. The Greeks said that music and astronomy were two sides of the same coin. Astronomy was seen as the study of relationships between observable, permanent, external objects, and music was seen as a study of relationships between invisible, internal, hidden objects. Music has a way of finding the big, invisible pieces inside our hearts and souls, and helping us figure out the position of things inside us. Let me give you some examples of how this works. It's a moving passage, so excuse me. One of the most profound musical compositions of all times is a quartet for the End of Time, written by French composer Olivier Messiaen in 1940. Messiaen was 31 years old when France entered the war against Nazi Germany. He was captured by the Germans in June of 1940, sent across Germany in a cattle car, and imprisoned in a concentration camp. He was fortunate enough to find a sympathetic prison guard who gave him paper and a place to compose. There were three other musicians in the camp, a cellist, a violinist, and a clarinetist. And Messiaen wrote his quartet with these specific players in mind. It was performed in January 1941 for 4,000 prisoners and guards in the prison camp. Today, it is one of the most famous masterworks in the repertoire. Given what we have since learned about life in the concentration camps, you might be thinking, why would anyone in his right mind waste time and energy writing or playing music? There was barely enough energy on a good day to find food and water, to avoid a beating, to stay warm, to escape torture. Why would anyone bother with music? And yet, from the camps, we have poetry, we have music, we have visual arts. It wasn't just one fanatic, Messiaen. Many, many people created art. Why? Well, in a place where people are only focused on survival, on the bare necessities, the obvious conclusion is that art must be, somehow, essential for life. The camps were without money, without hope, without commerce, without recreation, without basic respect, but they were not without art. Art is part of survival. Art is part of the human spirit, an unquenchable expression of who we are. And art is one of the ways in which we say, I am alive and my life has meaning. From these and numerous experiences, I have come to understand that music is not part of arts and entertainment, as a newspaper section would have us believe, or Jeon would like have us believe. It's not a luxury, a lavish thing that we fund from leftovers of our budgets, not a plaything or an amusement or a pastime. Music is a basic need of human survival. Music was one of the ways in which we make sense of our lives, one of the ways in which we express feelings when we have no words, a way for us to understand things with our hearts when we can't with our minds. Some of you may know Samuel Barber's heart-wrenchingly beautiful piece, Adagio for Strings. I mean, if you've watched Platoon, you know it. Or a couple of Oliver Stone movies. If you know that piece of music, either way, you know it has the ability to crack your heart open like a walnut. It can make you cry over sadness you didn't know you had. Music can sleep beneath your conscious reality to get at what's really going on inside us, the way a good therapist does. Music allows us to move around those big invisible pieces of ourselves and rearrange our insides so that we can express what we feel even when we can't talk about it. I mean, can you imagine watching Indiana Jones or Superman or Star Wars with a dialogue but no music? I guarantee you, if you showed the movie with the music stripped out, it wouldn't happen that way. The responsibility I will charge your sons and daughters with is this. If we were a medical school, and you were here as a med student practicing appendectomies, you'd take your work very seriously, because you would imagine that some night at 2 a.m., someone is going to waltz into your emergency room, and you're going to have to save their life. Sorry. Well, my friends, someday at 8 p.m., someone is going to walk into your concert hall and bring you a mind that is confused, a heart that is overwhelmed, a soul that is weary. Whether they go out whole again will depend partly on how well you do your craft. With that being said, thank you all again for coming tonight, and I hope you all have a wonderful evening. Therefore, please help me by welcoming our first duo, composed of Junihu and Sakurako Seiyama Luana. Now I'd like to welcome our first and only solo performer, Mateus Nogueira.
Thank you.
Our next performers are, ooh, sorry, there's a change in the program. I apologize. I just saw it right now. There will be no trombone duet. We will have our trombone and tuba trio composed of Mateo Javier Hester, Pedro David, and Fionn O'Keefe.
Thank you.
Now we are going to have our alto and baritone saxophone duet, played by Kayla Branch and Marina Tuller. And now our final duet before our very quick intermission, before we have a couple of orange juice and coffee and other assorted snacks. We're going to have a piano and voice, or soprano. I'm not sure. I'm not sure quite pegged Kayla out. Maybe soprano, may mezzo, I'm not sure. But out a piano and soprano duet played by Kayla Branch and Gustav Duarte Tiekel. Thank you.
you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight for half tonight. Walking in the winter wonderland.
Now, a very quick intermission, because we have to organize the stage for the ensemble performances. So if you didn't get a bite to eat, now is the time. Thank you very much. We'll get it organized. Then we have middle school and high school band. Thank you very much, everyone. Okay, I think we're about ready to begin again, okay? So, we just had our refreshments, a little bit bite to eat. Now we're gonna have our middle school band. And I'd like to say a couple of words before we begin. First of all, if you're able to put your phones on silent, the band would greatly appreciate it, especially during duos and trios. Their hands are cold, they're sweating, they're stressing out about an F sharp being an F natural. And sometimes a ding kind of breaks our concentration. So please, that would help us a lot. So, without further ado, I'd like to welcome, not yet, students who have played for, 4 months, 5 months, some of them, which is just astounding. I mean, from the first notes on the trombone that sounded like anything but a trombone to this, okay? So, I mean, I have the greatest gratitude to these students for keeping at it, you know, delaying gratification, showing perseverance, and just being the best that ERJ has to offer. So welcome, please, the middle school band. Just 4 months, point. Again, just 4 months, point. About 4 months. Before the middle school band goes, I'd like to... I know their names, just I just want to, don't want to make any mistakes, okay? Let's see if I know. In the alto saxophone, Ejikibu. Clarinet, Mirela Bajos. Clarinet, Eta Marawi. Clarinet, Maria Alicia Portela. Trombone, Laura Valpasos. Trumpet, Liam Potter. Trumpet, Pada Thornes. Trumpet, Carson Barron. I just want to make sure I don't make any mistakes. Yes, sir? I know, that's why I don't make mistakes. I know. Bass, Isadora Germini. And percussion, Martina Pesco. Everyone? And it's a one, two, ready? It's amazing, right?
Yeah.
Just 4 months, really? 4 months? So, for a couple of students that have played for a little bit more than 4 months, we have the high school band. Please, give it up for them. you know it, sing along.
Thank you.
Here we go. So, this was our last song. And before we go, I'd like to present the entire high school band. Flute section, we have Junie Hu. Clarinet section, we have Sakurako Seyama. Alto saxophone, but also baritone, Marina Tuller, and alto saxophone, Kayla Branch. Tenor saxophone, Mateo Nogueira. Trombone, Mateo Javier Hester, and Timber Javen. Tuba, Fiona Keefe. Piano, Gustav Garcia-Tinkel, and Margarita Brandão. Where's Margarita? Is she backstage? They're going to get Margarita. She'll be here. And Margarita Brandão, and percussion, we have our lovely team of percussion players. We have Beatriz Picozzi. Pedro Zamuju. Martina Pedro, I said it. Hakumani Cândido. And Isabella Piccolo, thank you very much. And it's 1, 2, 3. Thank you very much to the middle school and high school band. Come on, and obviously, come on, I just say, guys. And we're gonna leave the tuba so it doesn't fall. It'll be good. There we go. And it's 1, 2, 3. Thank you very much, family, friends, parents, guardians. Have a lovely drive back. Have a lovely holiday. Have a lovely new year. Thank you very much. Thank you.